Let's take a look at licensing in the WatchGuard ecosystem. To start with, you need to know there are two types of accounts, which affect how to think about using your licenses. There are end-user accounts, which are standalone accounts. Once you have activated a license in an end-user account, you are all set and ready to use the product. For WatchGuard partners using WatchGuard Cloud, you have access to a service provider account. This essentially means you can create and manage multiple end-user accounts, also known as subscribers, within your service provider. This gives you more flexibility in how to administer those accounts for multiple clients, but also means that after you activate a license, you need to allocate the license in WatchGuard Cloud before it can be used. In addition, end-user accounts can delegate account access to a service provider, which allows that service provider to access the end-user account in order to apply licenses and assist with the administration of their WatchGuard products. When it comes to buying your license, there are a few things to keep in mind. First of all, WatchGuard offers free trials for most of our products, so check them out to see if they are a good fit for you. For more information on how to activate a trial, check out the WatchGuard Trials video. WatchGuard offers term licenses for 1 or 3 years for all of our products. This is the only licensing option available to end users. In addition to term licenses, service providers can also purchase licensing through points and subscriptions. Points can be purchased in advance, then spent at the start of every month for the licenses you need. This lets you buy in bulk ahead of time and gives you more flexibility on a month-to-month basis. Subscription licensing means a service provider can deploy as many WatchGuard products to their subscribers as needed and will simply be billed at the end of every month for the usage. This offers the most flexibility but is only available for our cloud products. Let's take a closer look at how term licenses work. Say I purchased a 1-year, 50 endpoint license for WatchGuard's endpoint security product, EPDR. I will activate this license in January of 2024, and the timer starts ticking. I have 1 year until January 2025 to use the product on up to 50 endpoints. If I later purchased another 1-year EPDR license for 50 endpoints, I have a couple options available. I can combine the number of new endpoints with my existing license, providing me with 100 endpoints over the next year, or I can choose to extend my license expiration, which gives me 50 endpoints for 2 years. WatchGuard will automatically adjust the new expiration date to reflect the remaining value of the combined licenses. End users can only have a single license for any product active at once, like we see here. However, service providers can have multiple active licenses for the same product running at the same time. If I purchased a third 1-year EPDR license for 50 endpoints as a service provider, I could create a second container for these licenses. With all three of these licenses applied, I would have 2 active EPDR licenses for a total of 100 endpoints over the next year, with 1 license remaining for the year after. As I mentioned, simply activating the licenses as a service provider is not enough, though. You also need to choose how those licenses are allocated to your subscriber accounts where the product is actually used. After activating my 250 endpoint licenses, they are pooled together in WatchGuard Cloud, so I have 100 EPDR licenses that can be allocated from my service provider to my subscribers as I see fit. Maybe I want one account to have 15 licenses, a second account to have 20, and a third to have 50 licenses allocated. If an end user account has delegated access to me, I can even allocate licenses to their account as well. This means everything for that end user can be managed through my service provider, even though they have their own account. Let's take a look at how this works. From the WatchGuard.com homepage, I can log in to my account in the top right and reach the support center. I have some new EPDR licenses to activate, so I will hover over My WatchGuard at the top and select Activate Products. To begin, I need to enter the license or feature key that I purchased. Since I am adding this new license as a service provider, I also need to create a new friendly name for it. Think of this as the name of the container for these licenses. I recommend using a friendly name that will help you remember what this license is for. The summary section will tell me what changes I am making, so be sure to review that before proceeding. Once I am happy with this, I will click Activate and the changes are processed. On the Recent Activations page, we can see my new license. I have a second license I want to use as well, so I will repeat the process by clicking Activate Products at the top and entering the license key. When I select the friendly name, I could enter the name of the previous license I just activated to modify it. This would let me either extend the amount of licenses available or the expiration date. Once again, check the summary section to verify this is doing what you want. However, in my case, I am using a service provider and I want to create a second container for this license, so I will instead enter a new friendly name to do that. Once I complete the activation, we can now see both licenses on the Recent Activations page. Now that my licenses are activated, I need to head over to WatchGuard Cloud to continue. I will hover over my WatchGuard at the top and select WatchGuard Cloud. If I was using an end user account, I would be all set to start using WatchGuard EPDR. However, I am in a service provider account and need to allocate my licenses. From the dashboard, I will start by selecting Inventory at the top and Endpoint Licenses on the left. This reflects the licenses activated for my service provider, and here you can see the two licenses that I just added. Next, I will select Allocation on the left. Since I have not allocated anything yet, I will start by selecting Allocate Endpoints. From here, I can select the subscriber account along with the type and number of licenses I want to assign. I will assign two EPDR licenses to this subscriber. Note the expiration options at the bottom as well. By default, this allocation will not expire, but if I want, I can set a date in the future where these licenses will be unallocated from this subscriber account. I might set an expiration to match the date the contract with this client expires. Just don't forget to update that when they renew. Keep in mind, this expiration is not related to the expiration of the licenses themselves, only the allocation to this subscriber. As a service provider, you will need to keep your underlying licenses active with enough licensing in place to cover all of your subscribers. Once these licenses are allocated, you can see that reflected in the list and the account is ready to use the product. Let's say a few months later, this subscriber has some additional endpoints they want to protect and needs some more licenses. I simply need to select their account in the allocation list, and I can increase the number of licenses allocated to them, as long as I have some extras available in the pool. I also have an end user account that has been delegated to my service provider. Under Administration at the top, check out the Managed Access section to set up delegation. I want to go ahead and allocate some EPDR licenses to the delegated account as well, and it is as simple as going through the same process to allocate endpoints and select their account. For this delegated account, I will allocate 4 EPDR licenses from the pool. Hopefully all of this helps you get a handle on how to use licenses for WatchGuard services like Endpoint Security and AuthPoint. But what about WatchGuard hardware like Fireboxes or Access Points? Everything we just talked about still applies, but there is one other thing to keep in mind. If you are a service provider working with a delegated end user account, we recommend that hardware products that the end user purchases, like Fireboxes or Access Points, be activated in the end user account itself, not under your service provider. The end user can still be delegated to your service provider, so you can still assist with administration of those devices. But the reason for doing this is the configuration of hardware devices in WatchGuard Cloud are tied to the account the device is activated in. So in the future, if the end user no longer wants to work with a service provider, they will maintain the configuration for their hardware. For our cloud products, the configuration always lives with the account, no matter where the license comes from. So that is the basics of activating and allocating licenses for WatchGuard, but what about renewing your license? As a service provider, check under the Inventory Summary page to quickly see when your next license is expiring. From there, go to the Licenses page for the product to narrow it down. There are just a few other things to keep in mind. Let's say I have an existing 1-year EPDR license for 50 endpoints, and I purchase a second 1-year EPDR license for 60 endpoints. As I mentioned earlier, I can either add the total number of licenses together, creating a license for 110 endpoints, or I can extend the expiration date. When I extend the expiration with a different number of endpoints in my new license, the new number will take over and immediately change the total number of endpoints available in that container to match the new license I just activated, so I can start protecting the additional endpoints immediately. This will also apply if you extend the expiration using a second license with less endpoints than the original. The total will immediately change to match the new license. Expiration dates may also change to reflect the value of the remaining licensing. Sometimes you want to upgrade your product. In the other example here, let's say I've been using WatchGuard's entry-level endpoint protection, EPP, and want to upgrade to EPDR. I will purchase a new EPDR license and activate it on top of my existing EPP license. In this case, I will extend the expiration. WatchGuard will immediately upgrade the license to EPDR, and the remaining value of the EPP license will be combined with the new EPDR license. Keep in mind, if you are upgrading licenses like this in a service provider account, you must immediately update the license allocation in WatchGuard Cloud so your subscribers start using the new product instead. In summary, WatchGuard offers trials and a few different options for how you purchase and use licenses. Service providers can have multiple licenses for a single product running at the same time to pool them together. End users just need to activate their license with WatchGuard, while service providers must also allocate licenses in WatchGuard Cloud to their subscriber accounts. When dealing with WatchGuard hardware for end users, we recommend activating devices under their account so the configuration will stay with them. And for more information, check the WatchGuard technical search.